Everybody, it's Chanchai. I'm gonna spar with A Plus Destination. It's been a while, so I don't have too good a memory, but of how it was when I last sparred, but it's great that they're back in the VF. Now they're in another voice chat. Okay, awesome. So this will be fun. Let's start off with Leon. If I really want to play Leon, that's right. So let's see how this goes. My desk is a little messy right now, so. Been rearranging my setup. Trying to make it nice. Alright, A Plus, here we go. Now, I think last time I fought them was on PS4, so it's great to play them on RPCS3. Right, let's see how they play it. Very nice costume. Definitely a nice costume before. Alright, let's see how this goes. Right now, the lows get to them. Good. Doing really well though. Doing fine. Their pace is not the fastest. Very good. Excellent. He's in the back dash. Should be careful about that. If A did not come out, maybe they waited. Could be that they don't buffer, so I gotta be careful about that. So let's do backdash evade. That said. That does give them a hard time.
See, I thought I'm better.
Kind of nice for this game, nice observing. Let's test their throw ability. Let's test their throw escaping. So we're trying back. Forward. And we'll test neutral. Alright. So far, we haven't seen the throw escape yet. We're gonna keep testing. Good use of the board. He's doing very well. I gotta ask him about basketball. Very good. Forward throw. Good. The good thing is he's doing good straightforward attacks. Excellent. Very good. So, he doesn't buffer quite yet, but he is responding quickly. Very good, that was really nice. So I'm telling him that his decisions are good, but I'm not sure if he's used to buffering yet, and I'm not sure if he's used to throw skips yet. So I'm telling him to just do forward throw escape when he guards, and no longer than that. I'll try to just use forward throws. And because of this, I want him to work on letting his mental stack be used for getting the mechanics of throw escape down as a habit, and not so much on the guesswork. So I told him we're going to sharpen his VF skills. So I did tell him to try to buffer. And I did tell him to, but right now, focus on making sure that whenever he would guard, do a forward throw escape guard. I might make mistakes, but I will try to just do forward throws. Nice. That's good. That's really good. That's buffer timing. Good. There we go. So this is going to... See, he's doing really good. Now that he's working on this, this is just doing a lot better. So now we're going to fight, right? I told him that by focusing taking away the focus on the guesswork of the throws, he's seeing more about when throw happens, and I think it's like that game was a lot better as a result. You can kind of see the sharpness and
seriously. Round one. Ready, go!
Fight. That was very good. Very good. Very good. Playing a lot better now that my throw game is lost in that. That was really good. So now I have to play. This is going to be a lot harder to play handicapped on throws. That's beautiful. That was excellent. He's playing this really, really well. I like his use of Jackie's tools, so I told him that was good here. I like his use of Jackie's tools, so that was a really good game. Thank you. Very good.
Thank you.
Nice. He knows the combo? Very good. Excellent. That was excellent. That was really good. Now I get to give another round. I love that. Love that he knows to do that too. That was really good. So, because he doesn't buffer, I can't use evade too much, but I can spam the attacks a bit more. But that's why him using that EX high, is the combo is really good.
Take that!
Oh, that was really good. Excellent. Excellent. That was really good. I told him that that was a really good game. Those two rounds that he got were really well earned. He's doing well. He said that, yeah, he did more buffering, but in exchange, he forgot to break throws. I said, so that's good that he sees that, and he's doing well, but then he's got to keep working on throwscape. And I told him he's got this, and I think so too. I really do. He's a fast learner, actually. Some things just take doing in matches to do. Yeah, drills are good, but playtime too. Drilling is really good. Labbing is really good, but it's not the only thing. Playing long matches like this is really, really, it's really important, actually. I think it's the most important. But a lot of people nowadays do avoid it a bit because they've got the other ways. But I do want them being happy playing in the lab, playing against the AI too. That's more about
round two.
Very good.
Ready, go!
So I told him that he's doing great. Some Jackie tips. Beat Knuckle is so strong as a whiff punisher. Beat Knuckle punch is strong for combo. In the neutral, whether to do the punch follow-up or the kick follow-up is up to your confidence and your read. If you are sure you will counter hit, then punch follow-up for combo. If you feel you are guessing, then kick with a back step is follow-up is good. Also, a strong sequence with his 6-6 K plus G, that thrust kick he does that turns Jackie around, is to do the back turn kick and then tap 4 or tap back to do the back step after it, and then play around with the shuffle step options. If he does hit with the back turn kick, which is circular, the back step P is guaranteed, and he can do a 6K combo then. Also, if his back step parries a punch, same thing. I also told him that it's good to practice with Punish Beat Knuckle against the AI and against humans too. I love the way he uses that key, that move. Good. I'm gonna try playing Jackie and see if. I told him that he made good decisions because he said he felt like he made more clear and good decisions. I said he did, and he also used the ring well too. The Jackie is a lot of fun. This is going to be a lot of fun playing Jackie. Backdash, I see.
There you go.
I'm trying to get used to the timing of Jackie's voice, but I'll get there. Jackie's a character that I believe I can play really, really well, but I have to just get used to what moves I'm supposed to be doing in different situations. Nice. not so good. Very good game. Four, six, P plus K. I gotta use that too. That's the eye poke, I think. Nice ring out. Thank you. very good game. It's a lot of fun. 6K doesn't have that much range, so you gotta be very careful with it. So I have to do precision spacing if we're using that way. E knuckles a little easier, so I gotta start with that. Nice! He punched my 6K. Can't believe that did more damage. Jackie's range of all. I know how to fight against Jackie, but I don't know how to use him. It's a lot of fun though. Ready, go! Mars a bit slow, so I'll finish this one. So neutral is very awkward with them. Let's try, this is really awkward today. So really good. His neutral is very awkward, so using constant pressure is kind of the way to deal with him. So let's try that from now on. So I can do it with Leon, but with other characters I have to be a little trickier. So let's see if we can do this. Keep it up, you're doing great. All right, that was a lot of fun. Thank you, A Plus Destination. Again, really, really strong. I had a great time with that. And yeah, let's keep working on it. But the buffering is really important. It's hard to stress how important it is, even though I always talk about it. It's not that you only buffer. It's that you need to master it, because you can then do all the other stuff, because it sets your speed of play. It's if you can't do it, then you're always delaying, and your timing is mixed. But the problem is you're less in control of when you're playing at risk versus when you're not. So if you don't master buffering, then someone like my Leon is going to just launch you all day. I'm figuring it out with other characters, but I'm also trying to get the move interactions down. But part of the reason my Leon's defense is strong is from a lot of experience fighting a lot of different characters and kind of knowing, okay, I can go do this, and I can have this opportunity to do that. And I can do that at the speed that it needs me to, which starts with the buffer speed, but then also around that too. And but the stuff that they've already got shows they could do the buffer stuff. It's just a matter of getting used to it's a different mindset. Most fighting games don't want you to buffer as early as VF does, right? That would be bad, unless you're buffering specials or something, but they don't want you buffering normal attacks as early. So it is tough to go to VF, and here's a game that wants you to input almost everything early, to at least to start doing the option selects to understand why they work, or where they work and where they don't. So keep working at it. Just remember that you gotta just try to input as early as possible until you get a feel for how early is the right amount. And then you can move from there to being more deliberate, taking your time with the buffer. Because when you go from online to offline, you realize you have more time. That you can wait, or more like that you have to wait a little, even the buffer, and so you end up using that time much more for thinking, for making decisions. Some people it's to catch up and to play as fast as the game wants them to play. So some people need the offline because then they're allowed to play really, really fast. But for me, it's actually I slow myself down when I'm playing offline because I have more time to use and still buffer. So it's really important because of the decisions that we do make as we get stronger, as people get sharper. Decisions can narrow a bit, but they don't narrow, but they actually open up as well. And so when a player is able to control the buffer, then certain things become stronger against them, but some other things become weaker. And then as they start to use delay, then certain things that were strong against the buffer become weaker, and then certain things that were weak against the buffer become stronger. And then when they start doing the double delay by doing evade canceling, in which case their evade is punishing the buffer, but their canceling captures gets people that are holding defense too long or moving too much, but also setting up opportunities to whiff punish. But the weakness to that is that speed loses to a quick delay. And so this tempo war that you have with attacks is really important. Right now, if I play all frame tight, really fast, hyper moral, that's the thing that's going to give A Plus Destination kind of a hard time, except that they are doing some level of crushing with the way that they play. The crushing helps, but an opponent that is using every advantage to do like a mid, the crushing is not going to help that, right? And so frame tight mids is going to be really important, but also frame tight pressure, understanding where to fuzzy guard, becomes really strong against them. They may accidentally delay throw though, so that's a good thing, but it would be better if you intentionally delay throw as opposed to accidentally. So keep it up, you're really good. Get the throw escapes down. That's really, really huge. And I think they definitely have the skills and the smarts to do this really, really well. So I think they're going to master throw skipping soon. But the buffering is really huge. But, you know, learning some of the techniques that they're learning and learning Fuzzy Guard is going to help you with the buffering because you have to do it on the buffer. Or it's not that you have to, but effective Fuzzy Guard is happening on the buffer a lot of times. So, yeah, good stuff. Have a good one. But he does already do stuff. They do stuff that's already countering Fuzzy Guard, which is great, right? Jackie is doing sweep whenever people are Fuzzy Guard. That's how Jackie deals with Fuzzy Guard. Another way is to delay throw. And so, and they're doing, I think they did some of that too. So keep it up. You're playing awesome. Let's spar some more and let's level you up. Cheers.